Hello, welcome to the first video on the Film Music Learning and Appreciation series. This is an introductory video and gives you a high-level overview of the core elements in film music. The core elements of film music are melody, harmony, rhythm, form and dynamics. There are other elements like counterpoint and tempo which will get classified under these areas. We will also talk about other aspects like style, orchestration in a different set of videos. The subsequent videos will branch into each of these separate topics. Let us start with melody, something that all of us will be able to identify with. Does not matter if we are musically trained or not. Almost everyone can recognize popular songs, and that is through the melody. Melody has been defined in a couple of ways broadly. Succession of musical elements, a combination of pitch and rhythm, or a linear sequence of notes the listener hears as a single entity. Basically, we can view it as a horizontal portion of the composition when the notes are played in a linear or a sequential manner. In Western music, we depict it as staff notation. At this stage, don't worry about the notation. We will get into the details in a later topic. In Indian classical music, they are depicted through what is called as swaras. They are written in many regional Indian languages and also in English. In the world of film music, one needs to get a broad understanding of both these depictions. In the majority of the composition, the Western system is used to depict the melody. However, the Indian system is also used where the emphasis on the Indian raga is higher. Also, it depends on the proficiency levels of the musicians. Some of them prefer the Western notation, while some prefer the Indian way. Next, we will move into harmony. This is something very unique to Western music and is absent in Indian classical. Harmony can be explained as a combination of simultaneously sounded music notes or individual musical voices that group together to form a cohesive whole and that involves chords and their construction. As you would see in the slide, the notes are stacked vertically at the same time. We will have a separate series on harmony where we will get into the depths. These are also represented in instruments differently. The representation in piano and guitar are shown below. However, in a formal approach, the staff representation is typically used. Harmony has been used extensively in Indian film music. It has been leveraged in such a way that it blends well into the Indian raga structure. We will see more in the harmony series. To summarize, harmony is the vertical view of film music. The rhythm forms the third element. One can define the rhythm as the movement marked by the regulated succession of strong and weak elements and the placement of sound in time. In Western notation, it is notated by a time signature. As you see to your left, the time signature indicates the number of beats per measure and also the type of note. In the Indian classical notation, it is represented by the thal in Hindustani music or thalam in Carnatic music, like we say the teen thal or the adi thalam. Again, this is a separate study by itself and we will have a separate track for this. They are also represented in a specific language called bols in Hindustani or solkat in Carnatic. They are primarily meant for the percussion players. In the film music space, while the Western percussions and the rhythm guitarists go by the Western approach of time signature and drum notation, the Indian percussionists prefer the bols or solkat. It all gels together as a whole. The tempo goes with the rhythm and is a part of it. The tempo indicates the speed of the underlying beat. In the Western world, they are represented through the BPM, also called the beats per measure. In the Indian context, they are referred to as laya or layam, broadly the three speeds of slow, medium and fast. Generally, in most cases, the tempo is maintained throughout the song. However, there are instances when the tempo changes, which gives the added color to the song. The next major element is the form. The form gives the big picture to the whole composition. In the Western world, the song is built on the concept of phrases and periods. Basically, they are subunits which combine to form the larger melody. In the Indian classical world, they are represented either as the Sthayi Antara Mukta in Hindustani or the Pallavi Anupallavi Charanam in the Carnatic music. It will be interesting to note that the sheer permutation and combination of the phrases has given us so many songs. It is an interesting study by itself. In the film music world, traditionally, our songs have been built on the Indian classical structures of Antara Mukta or the Pallavi Charanam. Over time, we have adopted the Western structures into our composition. This includes the phrase period approach and also the popular verse, chorus, refrain approach in the Western world. We come to the last aspect, which is dynamics. Dynamics represents the variation in loudness between notes or phrases. It helps musicians sustain variety and interest in a musical performance and communicates a particular emotional state or feeling. In the Western music, they are mentioned in the staff sheet as symbols mentioned in the image. In the Indian system of music, the variations are taught as part of the training and not as a specific notational system. Some of these dynamics are inbuilt into the raga structure and its inherent color. Hope you got a taste of the elements at a high level. Honestly, this is a very simplistic representation. Each of these elements are large subjects by itself. The intention was to give a very high level view and not a deep dive in this session. Please do subscribe to these videos. Thanks for watching.